Time for more iOS developer portfolio reviews. My usual disclaimers apply. If my comments seem harsh, it's all out of love. I'm here to help you build a better portfolio. Like, I want to see you win. I want to see you get that iOS dev job. Also, while portfolios are useful, they're not the end-all be-all. For example, they're not all that helpful when getting jobs at a big tech company, but when it comes to getting hired at a smaller startup or as a contractor slash freelancer, they're insanely valuable. And lastly, I haven't done one of these in a while, so if you're new here and you want to see more, check out the playlist on my channel. Today's video is sponsored by Squarespace. First up, we have Julian Michaels. And I want to say right off the bat that I like the look and feel, the vibe of this, right? I like the grayscales. I like the big, bold lettering. I like the picture. However, the issue I have with this one, and this is a common thread that a lot of you need to work on, is the information hierarchy and bringing the good stuff up front, not burying it behind clicks. And that's unfortunately exactly what Julian did. Let me explain what I'm talking about. So great, we have the picture of Julian, have his name, a little bit about him, and then more about me, and then my content. Now this is what I'm talking about, the good stuff, right? If I'm looking to hire an iOS developer, projects, okay, that's one click. Cool, I see the app icon, little blurb. I want the good stuff, hit learn more. Ah, here we are, two clicks later, and then even scrolling down a little bit till I get to the screenshots and seeing the app in action. So again, we're two clicks deep, it's very buried. So I think this learn more page is very good. Aside from, you know, this is also on your home screen too. The center aligned text in these blurbs, like make it left aligned, maybe make them shorter. When things are centered aligned like that, it's really tough to read. But aside from that, I think this is a good learn more page, right? You tell me what the app does. I see some screenshots of it in action. I get more context. So I wouldn't mess with this one too much, but that middle step, right? Going from the home screen to projects with this, I would find some highlights in your learn more page and pull them out to the home screen so it's not buried two steps, right? And I'm not saying pull this whole thing out, just I'll use Creator View as an example, right? Not saying you have to do this exact layout, but bam, it's a quick little glanceable three screens of what the app does. So I'm not saying to use this exact layout, but that's an example of kind of what I'm thinking. Pull out some highlights and keep this top hero. I like this hero part, but this about me, move that down further, and then start putting your projects right here, right up front on the homepage. Again, the information hierarchy of bringing all that good stuff that's buried right up to the top. So I would have like a little preview of each of your projects. So again, something like little three screen preview, and then a little blurb what the app does, and then the learn more button. And that way I get this nice hero to learn who Julian is. I see your projects right away and I can dive in. And that's what I'm talking about bringing the good stuff up front. And then at the bottom, you can have about me, my content, etc. And I do like sharing the fact that you create content. Now I'm a little biased as a content creator myself. I know the work and dedication and effort it takes to consistently put out good content. So I encourage you, if you do create blog posts, YouTube videos, TikToks, share that on your portfolio and let them know. So if I get content, you can see the YouTube, TikTok, blog posts, and I can dive in more to learn more about you. And I can read your blog post to see like what you know. So again, you're putting your knowledge out there and letting people, I guess the big point of a portfolio is make it easy for someone to learn the best things about you. Because remember, the point of the portfolio isn't to get you the job. The portfolio gets you the interview. It gets you past that screening process. Okay, Julian, back to the about me. Like I said, just pull out some highlights from your learn more on your app, make it visually appealing and put it right under your hero and start showing your projects right away. Next up, we have Wadey here, and unfortunately, Wadey, this is an example of like what not to do. I rarely use absolutes by saying never do this because there's always usually some exception, but this stuff going on in the background, I will say never do this. It's a distraction, and like as I'm looking at the screens, I'm trying to figure out what the app does, and then, oh, it moved on me. Like, what's going on? I'm trying to figure out, and then it changes. So it's not useful, it's distracting. Like, I kind of get it's flashy, maybe it looks cool, but Don't do that. Especially like down here when I start to see your app. You know, I'm like, okay, cool. What's the app do? I don't know. It spun around. Okay, it's doing this. Yep. And then it spun around again. It's a horrible user experience. And I want to come back to this also about being careful how you market yourself. So you market yourself as a mobile developer and UI UX designer. So this tells me that you should probably know your stuff when it comes to UI UX. UX being user experience. So like I said, this is not a great user experience, distracting. You know, you can use motion and animation if that's really your thing, but make it slow, subtle. Make it so I can still see what's going on the screens. This jerky, fast, jittery, don't do that. But overall, aside from the crazy hero, like if you had a nice clean hero image behind there or something, I like the colors and the look and feel of the website. Overall, I like that. I think the social icon should be a little smaller just to not be so dominant, but you know, that's, you know, subjective. But like I said, you're advertising yourself as a designer first. And if I were hiring you as just a mobile developer, I could look past some of these design red flags. But if I'm hiring you to design and develop my app, these are red flags that would really make me pause. Because not only is it just the distracting flashiness, because that's the vibe I get from your website, is that as a designer, you go for more flash than usability and user experience. Like, as long as it looks cool and pretty animations, I don't care how usable it is. That's probably harsh, I get that. But I'm also saying that as I was like that in my first year or two as a developer slash designer. The apps I built were very flashy, looked cool, but might not have been the most usable. So I'm saying that again from, I used to be there, but that's a recommendation I would give you because again, back to user experience. It took me a while to see this. I was like, okay, you have one app. And then here you have this ghost button down here that says next app, because the focal point, right, is this big green button. That's what I want to click on, which takes me to the app store. But it took me a little bit to even know, oh, he has more apps. And I hit next app. And let's go back to this one. Look at this app once it's done spinning. It's okay, it's nothing great. The next app, okay, design is okay. I'm gonna praise you here in a second. This app, okay design. Here we go. This is a good design. This should be the first app. This is an impressive design. I like it, it's clean, minimal. That should be the first one. Even this file manager app, as simple as it is, again, clean, simple design. So you have your best apps, in my opinion, or at least that will give me a good first impression, buried behind six clicks, right? And it's just, back to the information hierarchy, because like I said, that's the common thread throughout all of these. As you know, as you're scrolling down a webpage, 100% of the people that come to your webpage will see your hero. And then maybe about 90% will get this far down, and then 70%, right? There's a continuous drop off as you scroll down. So that's why you wanna put the most important stuff up front. And then when you put stuff behind a click, like this next app, previous app, that falls off a cliff. Like maybe like 30% will click on that. So again, surface the most important, the most impressive stuff up to the top. Don't put it behind a click and don't have crazy animations that are distracting. But after all that bashing, Wadey, I think you're very close. I think, again, have a clean hero, not craziness. The overall look and feel of the website is pretty cool. Don't have this spinning. That's pointless. And it's just, it takes me a while to even like see what the app does because I got to wait for it to spin. Don't bury your projects behind next app, previous app. Pull those out. Just have like a list of apps. Let me scroll very quickly. And your wall of text here, that needs to be about half the size or at least formatted differently. I see you're starting to list out like some technologies, like you used MVC and implemented a food API. Maybe have like a little two or three sentence blurb and then some bullet points below it. Again, the idea is to make it easier on the website visitor to read and learn. When you have this wall of text, you know how it is. Like nobody's gonna read that. So make it easy to learn about you. And back to, I was like bashing you as a designer a little bit ago, I do wanna give you praise because again, this app is good. And then when I clicked on this design to explore it, I was like, okay, that's a pretty decent design. So you gave me some like mixed signals because my first impression, and again, a lot of people may not make it past the first impression, was, oh, he's a UX designer too. And then I was like, ah, this is bad UX. This is bad UX. He's burying stuff behind tabs. That's bad UX. It was not a good first impression on the UX designer part. So again, that's my warning to anyone that wants to market themselves as something, because especially with UX and design, it's a gamble. Now, if you are a great designer and great UI UX and you can show that off and you can develop, well, you're a unicorn. You're amazing. Absolutely share that. But if you say UI UX designer and then you showcase like not great designs, that's you're losing that gamble, if you will. So like I said, Wadey, I'm not saying you're a bad designer. I think you made some interesting, not great choices that are easily fixable. And I think you could have a pretty good portfolio if you fix those. Next up, we have Raul Lerman. And the first thing I want to point out about Raul's is a personal pet peeve of mine, but I think it's reasonable. You know, we're iOS developers, we're in the technology space. I think it's a bad look when you're using old device mockups. That might seem nitpicky, but it just looks dated, right? Like, it's cool that you show multiple platforms, like that is impressive. If you can show that, hey, I can do iPhone, I can do iPad, I can build a Mac app, that is a huge plus. So I like the idea of showing all that, even though to be blunt, it looks like it's just a collection view, which is gonna look good on all devices pretty much automatically. There's not a lot of extra work you had to do to get that. But I like where you're going with this. I would just use more modern mockups. And I know you have them because I scroll down and you have them. The overall flow, I like this. Screenshots, blurb, screenshots, blurb. In general, I'm going to pick it apart a little bit. Again, back to the information hierarchy. Your first app, aside from the hero, the first app that you're showing looks like it was done in 2014. Very iOS 7 looking, and even got the old iPhone. Again, put your best stuff first because you got good stuff at the bottom. So we're going to scroll down to that. Again, old app, simple app towards the top. All right, this is getting better. Again, now you can see the notch. It looks like a more modern, nice looking app. Keep scrolling down. All right, this is a nice looking app as well. More modern, same thing. Modern, nice looking app. But you see how far I had to scroll down to like get to that? So again, I know I'm repeating myself, but the information hierarchy is the common thread that I see through all of these. So in general, I like the flow, screenshots, blurb, screenshots, blurb. I would like to know a little bit more like about you, Raul, somewhere. Back to like Julian Michaels, right? Hi, I'm Julian. Here's a little bit about me. Here's my work. I think that's the standard structure that these should be. Here's who I am, a little bit about me. Here's my work. Keep it super simple. So yeah, I would elaborate on your blurbs a little bit more. Tell me what the app does. Tell me some of the technologies used. And again, move your good looking apps, the good modern ones, up to the top. And if there's something like this, maybe this app that's from 2014 was something you were just building when you first learned iOS development and you're no longer working on it. That's a great thing to put in the blurb. Say, hey, this is an app I worked on 8 years ago. I no longer maintain it, but I still wanted to share it. Just give a little context. So yeah, Raul, move your good apps to the top. Give me a little more context on you and use more modern device mockups. I know you got them. And lastly, I always like to share a GitHub repo type portfolio because yes, maybe not everyone can build a website, but the very least you can do is have a README on your GitHub. I will say here, JC Hammond, that if you are gonna have a README as your GitHub portfolio, just have it be a README. Like all this stuff is just, I gotta scroll so far. Again, back to people don't wanna scroll that far till I get to the good stuff. I gotta scroll halfway down the page and start getting to some good stuff. But again, little blurb about you. Here are my skills, here are my projects. I like that format. Little nitpicky stuff, right? You got the modern mockups, but you have 5 screenshots and then the rest 4, 4, 4. You kind of ruin the nice even flow. Maybe that's just me, but it looks, I don't know, just looks unprofessional when you have that unevenness of the number of screenshots in this giant space. But anyway, back to information hierarchy. I don't have all the context on this, of course, but by far your best looking apps is this Munify, right? Everybody can tell, look at that app, look at this app, and then look at this app, right? This one stands head and shoulders above. And I know design is subjective, but I think 98% of people like would agree with that. So again, move that one up to the top. What I wanna share here though is, again, being careful about what you say, because you have 2 sentences back to back. I think one is a little sketchy and then one is great. So we'll do the sketchy one first and then the great one. And again, it's all about how you're marketing yourself, how you're describing yourself. So this Munify, right? I undertook a holistic overhaul of the application's design. I use React Native. Okay, here are the 2 sentences. This transformation led to an unprecedented and intuitive design. That's a bold statement. And it looks like every other social media newsfeed to me. It looks pretty precedented. So just, again, if you're gonna make big, bold claims, be careful. I think the design's great, by the way. It looks like a great app, but just be careful overselling yourself. But okay, so now that I bashed that sentence, I think this sentence is great and a great example of like describing your work, right? So here you go. Furthermore, I engineered a versatile theme switcher for the application using React Native and TypeScript, providing users the flexibility to select their preferred dark or light modes, thereby enhancing overall user experience. That's great. Very objective, very factual. Here's what I did. It improved the user experience, great. Using these big words like unprecedented, it's just be careful with that. Now, the other thing I would like to see more here on this one is the technologies you used. So over here on Kuba's, another example of a GitHub, I think this image is kind of pointless and useless. Again, just tell me a little bit about you. Here are my projects. Doesn't even really show me anything. Anyway, I like that you have technologies used, right? App Clips, CloudKit, Core Data, Swift Package Manager, SwiftUI, Swift, great. I would like to see more screenshots of the app. Maybe like 2 or 3 screenshots and then technologies used. 2 or 3 screenshots, technologies used. 2 or 3 screenshots, technologies used. I think that would be good because you do kind of talk about like what you did here, implemented this, I'm not gonna read all of it, but incorporated Twitter login. So you do tell me what you do. I would just like to see more screenshots. But the reason this is good because it gives me something to be interested in or ask you, right? Like say I was interviewing you for an app that used Core Data and CloudKit. That gives me something to dive into. Because again, I wanna bring this full circle. The whole purpose of the portfolio is to make it past the screening phase and earn the intro call or earn the interview. That's the whole point of the portfolio. And I think if you can just tell me a little bit about yourself, present your projects in a great way, tell me about technologies you've worked with, you've used, that is a big step towards getting past the screening process. And I'm biased towards design. I know not all developers are designers, But remember, again, this is my bias, my frame is I've hired for small startups and contracting positions where the developer needs to have input on the product and needs to be able to have at least some good design sense. I haven't really worked with people that give you a full-fledged design and you just have to build it pixel by pixel. You don't have to think about design at all. I've never worked in that atmosphere. So that is why I am biased towards if I see a nicely designed portfolio like Julian's here. To me, that's extra points. If you can do that and show your work in a great way, tell me a little bit about yourself, I'm gonna wanna talk to you. That's just it. And I think most people in the smaller startup, contractor, freelancer world have that opinion. Again, if you're working for a larger tech company where you get pixel perfect designs, all you gotta do is build it, that is a different world, right? This portfolio is probably not as important. But again, for the small startup and contractor world, portfolio is imperative. And if you want to take all these tips, build your own portfolio to showcase your work, let me tell you about today's sponsor, Squarespace. Squarespace is an all-in-one platform to help you get that iOS developer portfolio, blog, or personal website up and running very quickly. Now I know, we're all developers with the skills and the desire to build the web page ourselves, but I would argue there's an opportunity cost to your time. If you're an iOS developer trying to build a great product, a great app, maybe spending a lot of time learning the ins and outs of web development, responsive design, isn't the best way to spend your time. That's why I recommend Squarespace to build that personal website, the blog, your portfolio, or maybe a landing page for your app. They have all kinds of beautiful themes and templates to get you started. They handle all the analytics and the SEO for you. Again, it just saves you so much time so you can get back to doing what you want to do, and that is building iOS apps. So when you're ready to get started, go to squarespace.com to start your free trial. And when you're ready to launch, go to squarespace.com/SeanAllen to get 10% off your first purchase of a website or domain.